6:52 right now, and it seems like there's never been a better time to be a Howard University Bison.
And the university is celebrating a big jump in the U.S. News & World Report's ranking of the best colleges and universities.
Molette Green sat down with the man behind this meteoric rise to the top, that is, University President Dr. Wayne Frederick. Molette, good morning.
Good morning to you. Everywhere you look, you seem to see Howard University mentioned somewhere. So in the first of our three-part series, we caught up with the university president to talk about his plans for the school's continued success. Howard University's choir performing on a national stage at the home opener for the Washington football team.
Oh, absolutely. It certainly was a big score. I was really, really happy to see them on that stage.
It's a good place to be for the historically black university situated on one of the highest elevations in D.C.
Would you call it the IT school right now?
So I always think that we are the IT school, if you ask me.
Not the case 2 years ago when campus unrest and financial scandals threatened the university's footing in the president's tenure, resulting in serious reforms.
They could be back here in the spring and take over the A building all they want. I know the university is in a better place.
Enrollment is up. The four-year graduation rate is near 90%. Howard's national college ranking soared to number 80 in the most recent U.S. News & World Report for best colleges.
I promised that we would try to move about 5 places per year. And obviously, we've moved 65 spots in the past 6 years.
Impressive, considering nearly 50% of students qualify for financial aid. They gain confidence here among their peers, who often rise to meet great expectations.
Howard forever.
It's Toni Morrison or Elijah Cummings or Vernon Jordan or Chadwick Boseman and now Senator Harris. We've been doing what we need to do to prepare our graduates to go out and change the world.
Frederick began his undergraduate studies at 16, received 3 degrees here. He walks from his administrative office into Howard Hospital, operating as a practicing surgeon with Bison pride.
It still takes me back to that, you know, young, impressionable teenager who had all these dreams, and this is a place that made it come to reality.
Can't believe he started school at age 16. I was nowhere in my head ready for college. Well, tomorrow, the university's COVID-19 outreach plan in communities of color. Back into you.
All right, Molette, thank you.
6:55 here, 4 things to know this morning.